Hey folks, today I'm going to show you how you can fix your USB drive. And by USB drive I mean pen drives, SD cards, external hard disks. To give you a little context, let's zoom to the past and see what I was trying to do. There we go. Dinosaurs? Wait, what? Oh, wrong timeline. Let's restart this time machine. There we go. I was trying to install Linux Mint and dual boot with Windows. Why Linux Mint, you ask? I will say, being a Windows user, I am oddly excited about Linux and Mint got my attention. There are many ways I should do this, but at that time I thought burning ISO file on a pen drive and then booting into the Linux Mint installer would be the best way. And the Itcher was the perfect choice. If Itcher sounds stranger from the past, see the description to learn more about it. Everything came out to be good and I successfully installed Linux Mint. That was an ocean full of contents. Let's come back. I want my pen drive to go back to normal. Previously I installed Windows and that was easy. I just reformatted it and reclaimed its space. But is it true for the Linux Mint? Let's find out. Let's plug in my Linux pen drive and see what's going on. Wait, what? My pen drive is only of size 2 MB? How's this happening? Hey Cortana. You know what? I'll do this myself. As you can see, I still have 7.5 GB of space as before. The thing is that it has formatted it such that Windows cannot read it, like I cannot read German. But unlike me, Windows shows no interest in learning how to read. Let's open command prompt to fix this problem. Remember to open it with administrator privileges. Type diskpart in it. Type list disk. Choose your disk. In this case, disk 1 is my disk. Remember to choose this carefully, otherwise you will lose data. Don't wanna end up like this guy. Now type clean. This command will clean all the partitions present in that disk. Although it has encountered error, but you will see that it has successfully cleaned the partitions. Here you can see that. Now you have to create a new simple volume and remember to format it as NTFS. Regardless of FAT32, it was the default. After a really long time, the format will be completed. And then you have to just reformat it with your FAT32 and set everything to its default. You'll see in a moment. So right click on it, select format,